All right, welcome to the show. Of course, this is Man Cave right here on the Public for Show, and we are talking today about a very interesting topic. It's that of Ben 10s and cougars. So that is
not a cougar.
That's definitely a Ben 10.
If you want to join the conversation, the hashtag to use is for breakfast, and we'll also be taking the SMSs on 22422. Of course, joining us, Kama K, is Sheila Komboka, Roy Karuizi, the crazy guy, Pastor Kulia, the even crazier guy, and me, the sober mind.
Wow.
You're sending us over
Bogo. You guys are the crazy guys.
Excuse me.
Yes, sir.
Is the Kulga and the Ben 10 the same people we were calling at our age, mm-hmm. sugar mummies and sugar daddies?
They have a bit more style now.
So the cougar is basically someone who chooses to date someone who's extremely way younger than they are.
Okay. And that's a lady.
Yeah, that's a lady.
Okay.
And the guy who's way younger is called the Ben 10. Don't ask me how they came up with this name. But then I'm like, okay, what do they call the male version of the cougar?
The male version of the cougar
is called a shuja.
A shuja.
It's called a hero.
It's called a hero.
A hero.
Muzalendo.
Oh. Oh. Patriot.
A representative of the Boma.
Of the Boma, yes. So there we have a...
Are they supposed to, maybe the cougars, are they supposed to be married or divorced? Or they are both?
Actually, there are two types of cougars. There's, look at me speaking like I'm a professor.
You've done cougology.
Cougology. Make sure we up with Gina.
Cougologist. No, there's two types of cougars, of course. There's the one who's married and is not sufficiently taken care of, her needs. And there's the one who's, you know, divorced or never been married and just decided that they want something that they can be able to control. I feel like in the cougar relationship, it's all about control.
Mm-hmm.
But the majority, I think, where they sit is actually most of them tend to be in the ones who are married. Because I think a lot of them come out of frustration.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah. Rather than the ones who are just single and decide. Mm-hmm. So ones who are single are still jerry.
When they're going for the young men, are they willing to show the exes that we are still there?
I don't think this has anything to do with
the
exes. Because at the end of the day, here's a situation where every self-respecting 60-year-old guy who can be able to, you know, is mobile and, you know, is healthy, is not looking for a 50-year-old or, you know, someone around his age range to mate with. He's looking for the youngest collegist, fresh out of high school kind of girl. Yeah, colleges. Okay. The fresh out of high school kind of girl. So here's the situation.
Point is very simple. Cougars are a result of rejection by men.
Exactly.
So you can't just wake up as a cougar and say, you know, I'm like,
it's time to cougar life.
No. And maybe I've been focusing on my career, no offense, for all this time, and maybe I've not been focusing so much on this, and I've not been lucky.
So let me go out shopping.
This is not even a career.
That's what I'm saying. Maybe it's just that you just do want to date, and then you realize, oops, I'm 55 and I don't have a dude, so the dudes who are 55 might not want to date you.
Yeah.
So now you go for the thing?
Let's be realistic. There are two main reasons why we actually have this situation today. I think one of the main reasons is one, as she has tried to politely put it, rejection. This is the fact that a lot of women, they know that a guy is going to dog at some point in their marriage, and now she reaches a point where she decides, you know what, I might as well get my own. Because I'm not going to get the respect and the love and the attention I'm meant to get from this guy. So let me look for it elsewhere. So that's the one who's in marriage. The second one is a result of, I'll put it as politely as possible, it's women empowerment. So women who are in charge and in control have decided that I've got, what are those things for the quarry? Money. Yeah? Some sacks of money, some few billion. When you've got a kidogo billion, you decide now you can afford to buy for your
Do these people, both parties, do they value the dignity and integrity in life?
Yes. Okay, here's the thing. Look, at the end of the day,
they're practical, they're realistic.
You know, here's the crazy part about...
No, he's asked a question.
That's what I'm asking. First things first, we have to acknowledge that this is a patriarchal society. We wouldn't even be having this conversation if it was guys and young chicks. This is, in fact, this is the standard procedure. Mm-hmm. You're in top restaurants, you can go to some that I can't even mention, mm-hmm. top restaurants too, and you'll find an old guy. For real. Like, we can see the kiwi that you have applied on your hair.
Yeah.
Like, you understand?
Yeah.
Because you can, you, there's the white in front of
my
hair. And the
chile
you're with, as in for real, can be your great granddaughter.
Yes.
Not even granddaughter.
Okay.
Great granddaughter.
Yeah.
So when you see the same situation with a lady, it becomes a conversation.
Mm.
It becomes, first we need to give them a name, cougars, and then we need to address the guys who are dating them as Ben 10s. But how come we're not having the same conversation with them?
Because it's
not
traditional
society.
It's just not traditional. It's
There's nothing traditional about
traditional.
A 70-year-old guy going for a 19-year-old
girl. Let me tell you why.
That
it's
is disgusting.
Why, why we're seeing it going against the grain is because we're feeling women are taking charge. It's looked at the point of authority. This relationship is about older versus younger, is about who is in charge. It's not the argument.
Right, right.
Older versus younger is about who's in charge. People are used and more inclined to believe that guys should be the ones holding the relationship, running the show. That's tradition. So when something has gone against tradition, we're not saying it's wrong or right. We're just saying it has gone against tradition, where now it's a woman has authority, is the one who's got the age command, and she's in charge.
So
we're not used to women being in charge to that extent.
So one of the reasons that you're saying is for this thing, the emergence of the Ben 10s and the Cougars is what?
Women empowerment? Shifting power.
So women should not be empowered. So are you saying a woman who is financially stable and all that should not suffer any and a diminished chances? So you're saying men are daft?
No, it's not that you're diminished.
No, let me cut you short, guys.
Yes.
And maybe I change a bit of this conversation.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Does this woman who is a Cougar have a son?
Sometimes anakuja
would she like what she is doing to a young one has to be done the same by another lady? No. The answer is no. Nobody would like her son to be a Cougar or a Tibetan or whatever. Everybody wants a child who is having morals.
Yes, exactly.
If you have morals, why are you making your morals decay?
Mm-hmm.
And then you become something as if your children are bright. They don't see what you are doing. You see, our children does not hear what we tell them. They hear what they see.
Mm.
And they can see the mother has become a Cougar.
Mm-hmm. But you know
what example are you sending to the children?
Because chances are their father has
left.
You know, let me tell you something,
yeah?
I know you want to talk about morals and whatnot. But this always, funny enough, this story of morals always comes when women are involved. You understand? I'm sure you have friends, who are dating girls who are a third their age. Do you talk to them about
their morals?
They're everywhere. From
Let
me tell you something, bro.
Okay,
not everybody who believe in what I believe.
Okay.
And not everybody who believe the Bible. Not everybody who believe other books. Everybody is having his way of doing things.
Yes.
But the problem is, we form a habit, but the problem of the habit that you have formed decides our future.
Look, let me tell you something.
You're saying this relationship won't last.
Most women want...
Cougars and Ben 10
can't last.
It can't last.
Of course.
It has no future.
It is never a relationship of... It's not a long-term conversation. Look, I'll tell you, I'll be honest with you. If you're, say, 45, you've been pushing your career, you know, you haven't found the right person to settle with, it happens. It doesn't mean there's anything wrong with you or you chose your career over marriage. You understand? Maybe you chose not to settle. Maybe you didn't find the right person. But it reaches a certain age where you can't find a suitable partner in terms of age.
Mm.
Why? Because the person who 45 who's single, he's not trying to date
my
a 45-year-old.
Dear.
He's trying to date an
so,
20-year-old.
No,
what happens?
No, no,
so what
no, no.
happens?
Have you guys, let me ask you this, right?
So what
so
happens?
So men are able to handle compare with you know how guys can take on Ben 10s any day. Yeah, the thing is compare with play serious game.
Yes.
And you're saying that women are not able to take on their younger counterpart.
That's
working no way by a longer one. That's it. Take on the competition.
That isn't the point. You see, at the end of
the day... Are you saying you're actually accepting failure to get guys within your age range and now going to collect our guys of cooling lollipops?
That
so
is...
Guys you're getting.
You know what? You're actually misconstruing the conversation. Because what I'm saying is, at the end of the day,
mm-hmm.
these relationships are formed out of, you know, necessity. You have needs. There's things you want. You want companionship. Okay. And the man who you think is your age, who society is telling you that that is the person you should be dating with, you should be dating. Any self-respecting lady will not go for someone. If your last person you were dating was 21, I'm not going to come play in that,
let
in
me
that
ask,
relationship.
Let me ask,
and you're 45.
Let me ask Kwamboka this.
And you're 45.
Yeah.
Because you are a lady. When do you need man most? Is it when you are young? When you have grown old?
I think at all sectors.
She's very neat. Let me tell you one thing. We can look at the positives.
Right.
When it comes to the positives, it's very clear where the positives are with Ben 10 and Cougars. First of all, Cougars are doing a good service to the youth in terms of youth investment. Investment in the youth. Financial. You know, a lot of the funds have failed to give youth tools.
Uh-huh.
They are providing for the youth industry. And then, of course, job employment. Yeah, the job issue of employment. They're providing employment. Okay, she like
having a lot of time to waste, because this is called time wasting.
Exactly.
No, but you see, the thing is,
so it's wasting time. It's wasting
this
time.
This is a vicious cycle, guys. At the end of the day,
and again, when I am young, why should I go with a woman who cannot give birth, and maybe I call the child after my mother or after my father?
But I think
I'm wasting a lot of my energy.
Your good energy.
My both are benefiting from this relationship.
I think at the end of the day, you must realize that this relationship is not formed because of no necessity. There's no young man out there who maybe can be able to get a job or whatever, and they decide this is what I'm going to do if it's against what they want. You understand?
Mm.
So, but I feel like the situation of the reverse for the guys and the young girls, it's not even a necessity to rule. It's just
but
guys competing with each other.
That's
what I'm saying. So the situation, whether it's reversed or whether the guy is young or the lady is young, we must accept that this is a relationship that, whether you speak of morals or necessity, it is happening.
Mm-hmm.
It is happening.
All right, so I just add, get some feedback as well. We have Steve Nyabo who is saying that the reason why ladies are held to a higher standard is, if we think about it, if women in general were unavailable to men's immoral advances, men would align.
Mm-hmm.
So if
this is you putting women to a higher moral standard than guys. What is happening.
Obviously, God made women to have greater morals than men.
I don't think we're going to take God advice from you. Let's talk.
let me tell you something. Else. There is when you misuse a chance.
Yeah,
it is called abuse. I think Cougars and Bentens, they are abusing marriage.
Mm.
Yeah, they are not good examples. We cannot follow them, but we cannot finish them, because also devil needs people. Now, what I'm trying to say here is,
whenever the devil enters this room, it's time for me to stand up.
Okay, uh-huh.
It's time for people to bring up quality children.
Mm.
Yeah. Give your children time and quality time. Yeah? Show them the need of life, values of life, values of marriage. Because like now, why I'm not on her side so much, but why should a man go to outside the country, stay there for 12 years, and expect to find the same lady the same way he left? Even if the guy is sending money.
Mm.
This woman did not come out of their homes because of money. They need companionship. So whatever is going on between the Benten and this Kuruga
thing,
is they need one another, but they are getting it from the wrong place.
Yeah.
I agree with him.
Right.
Yes, raise your kids with the values, but also have values.
Yes,
because you see, you're addressing the kids.
Mm.
Yeah. It's not the kids that are the problem.
It's not the kids.
Keep in mind,
it's
not the Bentens or the Clandes that have the issue.
In fact, the kids are
ask
susceptible
any
to...
In fact, you know what? I think our next show should be, we should talk to some campus girls and ask them, is there any single campus girl or guy who's not been advanced on by a friend's parents, uncle, aunt? So the issue is not with who you're raising.
Then we have to go back to the moral of the case.
Let's stay back on topic, and just to paint the picture of that this stuff is actually happening. It was addressed recently in one of our shows here, and we want to listen to it. Let's listen to it.
After that, I think Jubilee have to decide who they want to face with.
We talked about people who are not serious. But also, as I told you, Nairobi is a serious place. It's not a place for Ben 10s.
I'm sorry, who's the Ben 10?
I'm just saying, I mean, you can't elect a Ben 10 in Nairobi. You can't elect a cougar in Nairobi.
Go on, Governor, you're on the roll. No Ben 10s and no cougars.
So they have a no Ben 10s and no cougars. So this stuff is actually happening.
No, that's exactly the point.
On all levels.
Yes,
it's happening on all levels. And that's the thing we have to realize. It's already part of the fabric of our society right now. And I think we need to realize, why does it exist? Remember, we have to look at the problem, why it exists. Then you know how you can resolve it.
Why does it exist? Is it because that...
We said it clearly exists because of two things. One, there's a financial problem, right? Where young guys are looking for quick gains and quick and easy wins. We're still claiming some of them come from good families where they have money, but they're looking for easy wins, right? Yeah. From the lady's side, we're saying she is lacking the respect and relationship she's been looking for with the guy she's been with. So she's seeking love. So there are two things that are happening here. And I think men have been blamed for both. One, the guys up there are not actually beginning to give the women the relationships they need. They're busy going, as you said, chasing young ladies.
Yes.
While the young guys are busy on the fastest route up. Because women now have the financial capacity to provide for them.
I think it's also so much being pushed because of men being lazy.
Men are lazy.
Men are lazy.
Generally. Generally. Areas.
By nature. You know, when they were created by God, they found fruits everywhere. So they were not laboring for anything. But when ladies came, they started helping men. Whenever you become lazy, you have to look for quick money. And quick money goes easily. That's why you never ever save quick money. And let me surprise you. In Proverbs chapter 7, that's full of Ben 10 and Kulga.
Oh!
Proverbs chapter 7. Go and read it.
Does it have pictures?
It shows
a lady who is old,
how they look.
Going out on the streets to look for young men because the husband
is away.
And actually she's saying, and my husband has gone with a bag full of money, so they are not poor. So if you are a Kulga you want to be one, you must be rich.
Okay.
And that's why we're saying, but it's just the two things.
It's the two things.
We've just said here, it's caused by two values that are missing here.
Mm-hmm.
One, overvaluing wealth, finance, by young people today. That's why you also have socialites at the end of the day. There's so much value placed on wealth. Secondly, it's lack of respect for companions.
Yes.
Okay.
If you resolve those two issues, they're good.
Right, okay.
That's it.
We need to move forward because leo nini metupatia kisogo sana, but let's...
Shila.
For me, at the end of the day...
Meme sina kuga.
Kuna bongo.
Let our record reflect.
But you know what? At the end of the day, I think it all comes down to an individual because these advances are made. And for example, for the Ben 10, like we're saying, it's a financial... you want to pay your school fees, you want to dress well. And by the way, did you know that a guy who's a Ben 10 chances are has a girlfriend.
Yeah.
It's the same thing with the Klande. The one that you're paying rent for and she's got a boyfriend there who's actually doing the real job.
That is why the whole of this thing is called immorality.
No, but it's
Yote, it's immorality.
Yeah, but you have to have a substitute. Even when you're playing in a team, ukiumia.
So you stand for the substitute.
So for me,
I'm just saying it's natural that would happen.
For me, my answer to this whole story is that I'm of the thinking that when it comes to, before you take that step that you're, because cougars and bentens and clandes are all created from people who are in relationships, that they're unhappy in their relationships, and then they go out looking for substitutes, and people end up being collateral damage. Mm. And at the end of the day, it's creating such a vicious cycle that people are growing up not caring, not respecting
relationships anymore.
So, For me, at the end of the day, I feel like the solution is, if you get into a marriage, know what it is that you're getting into.
And respect
And respect it. Yeah. And if you know you're not going to respect it, step out of it. Yeah? Don't create, because this one is going out to look for young people, then even me, I'm going to look out for young people.
I think what we've actually all agreed is the fact that this relationship is not real.
It isn't.
It's not real. And it won't last.
That's why
it won't last.
It won't last. It's not a real relationship. Mm-hmm. But it has got real gains. The gains are real. There might be short-term vision next week, not vision 2030, mm-hmm. but the gains exist clearly. Right?
What's the most popular Ben 10 Cougar situation we have seen? Maybe
Wamboi and
Mbogwa.
Yeah. That one worked.
Yes.
No? But you can't actually not
at the end of that one was Mbogwa.
No, that one was called Crazy Love.
But it works.
That's a Cougar relationship.
Says it's an opportunity for young guys to generate revenue, just like you're saying. And then Abu Clip says, when I'm old, because I have earned them the hard way, and to cater for my needs, when energy is gone. So that's why he says, because I asked, would you date somebody younger? That's his reason, because he has energy. And then Miller Gibbs says, I love the conversation, and this is a crisis we are facing, and it's real. As usual, Combox, our kind of fans, Combox, you are on point.
All right. You're supporting him on the basis of the fact is that women feel they're being victimized. The reality is...
No, there's no victim in this story.
But my question is this, and let me twist the conversation. You know, you're saying there's a lot of gain, right, in terms of...
Youth fund.
But what if it's the other way? Because a man is still supposed to provide. So what if you're 25 and you go and say, okay, mimi sasa hawa watu wangu wamenichosha, wacha nitafute msichana. I have money. Tenderpreneur pengine nimekula kama tender 5 or 6, or I just have money 26 or 7. And I go for an older mama and say,
we are
for
my call time wasting.
Time wasting, because I'll agree with him, because usually look at the Benton situation. Is a guy who's going for a wholesale offer. He's getting a girlfriend. He's getting a mother, he's getting a bank, all in one deal.
No, but this one has money.
I'm
but
saying.
In this case, the guy is not getting either of those things.
Yeah.
So this is a sign of madness, first of all. That's a sign of madness.
No, for the first time, let me show
you. You need two doctors. One for just the outside of the head and one for inside. Because there's really a serious problem.
No, but guys...
Because these are not real relationships. I've told you, any time that the gap between the two is 10, 15 years, it's a lost cause.
Look, I don't agree with that. Look, at the end of the day, whatever you decide for yourself, yeah, it makes sense. There's no opportunism that is involved. And you're just trying to live your life. And it's not... immoral, it's not hurting anyone. I think you should go for it. Whether your friends tell you, Sidri, oh, this is not blah blah blah, if it makes sense for you and that's what you want and you found love in it, go ahead and do it. It's not madness. Mm-hmm. Yeah, madness is when you walk into a relationship, you know there's nothing in it for you, you know there's no feelings involved, but you're just trying to get cash out of it,
of course, and
at the same time trying to milk feelings out of it. Okay, and you know that this is a financial
We're agreeing with what just
your final comments as well.
If you've entered, for us guys, I said anything when you enter a relationship, you know that it's what I want to invest in. If I want to invest in a good relationship, or if I want to just invest for the sake of getting finance, it is my business.
Yes.
Right, as long as you know what you're getting into, then we cannot actually justify, attack, defend. It's all about what you want to get out of it. As long as you're clear. Let us be very clear that those relationships don't last. So if you're going in there for finance, get your finance. Uh-huh. If you're going in there for the sake of relationship, it's a risky way to run things. Uh-huh.
Just to finish my point.
When it came in quarters.
You guy, you know you're that guy for commenting on everything.
Okay, yeah.
For me, my advice would be, for young people out there who are, you know, because you're being sucked into this relationship. I'll be honest with you. These babas and mamas are going to campuses to search for these students. It is ridiculous. And it is, as you do it to this young person, someone is also targeting your child, okay? And this child, you're creating them in a system where you can't function in a normal relationship. You either have to look older or you have to look younger. So be responsible with what you're doing. But if that's the life that you have decided for yourself, go ahead and But I wouldn't advise it, especially for the young people. Just avoid it.
I just want to add something that Sheila said, and I just think it needs to be reinforced. Whatever it is, it never ends well.
Yeah.
Mm. It never ends well.
Yeah.
So you enjoy the fun while you
enjoy
can.
The money.
Enjoy the short happiness. But it never ends well.
Let us respect marriages. Let us respect one another. Let us create habits which are we shall not regret at the end of the day. So dignity and integrity will make you leave behind children who can be relied on by the society.
Yeah.
So God bless you. I love you guys.
All right. Some final comments here from Olien Kelvin and Afema. You know, that he agrees, and it would be much better if both men and women became immune. Then Makamba Mkenya anasema cougars want, let me paraphrase for him because of watershed, cougars want companionship from Bentens, Benten want money. Full stop. That is your comments as well. Want to thank you guys so much. From that, we'll be back next week as we show a picture there of what the cougar event looks like.
My comment is this, right? I just have to show you this, yeah? In all these things where the cougars have been shown, how come they always wakubwa wakubwa? But they're not thin ones.
That's a stereotype.
Better end it there, but like, I guess the takeaway is, you know, whatever you do, just make your decisions wisely, and at the end of the day, you're the one who's going to live with them. So that's the takeaway from today as well. Next week, we'll be back, same time, and the same panel, hot topics as well. The hashtag #PowerBreakfast, thank you guys for commenting on it. And 2242, we read some SMSs. My name is Ulu Saburu, reminding as always that successful people look like you and the great Manchester United.
Come on!
To NRA.